Hi, my name is Mark. Greetings to all my fellow truth seekers and brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ. In part one of Did Jesus Die for All of Mankind, we left off with 1 Timothy chapter 1 and verse 15, which says, "This is a faithful saying and worthy of all acceptation." What is a faithful saying that we should all accept? That Jesus Christ came into the world to save sinners. Why is it that some just do not accept that Jesus came and died for all sinners? Let's continue in this same context with 1 Timothy chapter 2 and verse 1 through 6. "I exhort therefore that first of all, supplications, prayers, intercession, and the giving of thanks be made for all men, all of mankind, for kings and for all in authority, that we may live a quiet and peaceable life in all godliness and honesty. For this is good and acceptable in the sight of God our Savior." Why? Why is praying for all men acceptable in the sight of God, who will have all men to be saved and come to the knowledge of the truth? "For there is one mediator between God and men, all of mankind, the man Jesus Christ, who gave himself a ransom for all of mankind, to be testified in due time." Also we read in 2 Peter chapter 3, verse 9, that God is not willing that any man should perish, but desires that all of mankind to be saved. "The Lord is not slack concerning his promise, as some men count slackness, but is long-suffering to usward, not willing that any man, any of mankind, should perish, but that all of mankind, should come to the knowledge of the truth." Now the knowledge of the truth is that Jesus died for all of mankind, and not for just a certain select few, who are the so-called chosen of God before the foundation of the world. Please read John chapter 12, verse 32 and 33, where Jesus says, "And I, if I be lifted up from the earth, will draw all men unto me." This he said, signifying of what death he should die. Now the death that Jesus died was a ransom for all of mankind. Matthew chapter 20 verse 28 says that Jesus gave his life as a ransom for many. Please take a look at Isaiah chapter 53 verse 3, which clearly states that Jesus died as a ransom for all of mankind. "But he," speaking of Jesus, "was wounded." Why? "For our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities, and the chastisement of our peace was upon him, and with his stripes we are healed. All we like sheep have gone astray." In other words, all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. "And are therefore the Lord has laid on him," Jesus, "the iniquity of us all of mankind." Now take a look at Isaiah chapter 43 verses 3 through 10. "For I, Almighty God the Father, am the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel, your Savior. I," still speaking of Almighty God, "gave Egypt," referring to the world, or all of mankind, "for your ransom, Ethiopia and Seba for you, since," or because, "you," speaking of Jesus, "was precious in my sight. You have been honorable, and I have loved you. Therefore," or "for this reason, I will give you men, all of mankind, for you, and people," again, all of mankind, "for your life." You see, the truth of the matter is that Almighty God gave men, that is to say, mankind, to his son Jesus, because Jesus was obedient unto death on the cross. Philippians chapter 2, verses 8 and 9 shows that after Jesus became obedient unto death on the cross, Almighty God highly exalted him. "And being found in the fashion as a man, he humbled himself and became obedient unto death, even the death of the cross. Wherefore, or for this reason, God also highly exalted him and given him a name which is above every name. Then we read in Hebrews chapter 12 and verse 2 that there was a joy that was set before Jesus, and it was this joy that was set before him, which was the reason why Jesus suffered what he suffered. And this joy was the redemption of mankind. Take a look at Proverbs chapter 8, verse 30 and 31, which is a type, figure, or shadow of Jesus. Then I, speaking of Jesus, was by him, Almighty God, as one brought up with him, and I was daily his delight, rejoicing always before him, rejoicing in the inhabitable part of his earth. And my delights, or joy, were the sons of men. John chapter 6, verse 45 says, it is written in the prophets, and they shall be taught of God. Every man, therefore, that heard and has learned of the Father comes unto me. Again, it is by the foolishness of preaching and the teaching God's word, the gospel of Jesus Christ, that God has chosen to be the way to save any and all of mankind who chooses to believe. Please take a close look at Acts chapter 17, verse 26 and 27, and then verses 30 and 31. And has made of one blood all nations of men, all of mankind, for to dwell on the face of the earth, and has determined the times before appointed, and the bounds of their habitation. Why? For what reason? That, or so that they, all of mankind, should seek the Lord, if haply they should find him, though he be not far from every one of us. And the times of this ignorance God winked at, but now commands all men everywhere to repent, because he has appointed a day in which he will judge the world in righteousness by the man, speaking of Jesus, whom he has ordained, whereof he has given assurance to all men, in that he raised him from the dead. Now if you continue reading the next three verses, you will see that some of mankind which heard the truth mocked and rejected the truth, and therefore remained lost. And yet some of mankind received the word of truth and made the choice to believe. Why? Please take a close look at 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verses 1 through 4. Therefore, seeing we have this ministry, preaching the gospel, as we have received mercy, we faint not. But having renounced the hidden things of dishonesty, not walking in craftiness, nor handling the word of God deceitfully, but manifesting the truth, commending ourselves to every man's conscience in the sight of God. But if our gospel be hid, it is hid to them that are lost, in whom those who are lost at the moment, the God of this world has blinded the minds of them which believe not. Why? Why does Satan blind the eyes of them that believe not? Lest, or for fear of, the light of the glorious gospel of Christ, who is the image of God, should shine unto them. So you see, my dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, it is not God that predestinates some people to reject the gospel and remain lost, but rather the enemy of God, Satan the devil, who is the one who is keeping man from seeing the truth and coming to God by repenting and turning from their wicked ways. God is not the one preventing the wicked from coming to him, because the word of God clearly shows that God is drawing all men unto himself. Please be sure to view part 3 of 3 of Did Jesus Die for All of Mankind, where we will look at the drawing of God and the opposing influence of the enemy, Satan the devil. Thanks for watching. To find part 3 or any of my videos, please click on my username, A Matter of Truth.